Hi, everyone. Welcome back to our ongoing series on how to create a life operating system in Notion. We're in the final few videos looking at the knowledge management section of the overall system. And in these final few videos, we're going to add some ways to enhance and optimize. These are nice little touches that can really be added to pretty much any knowledge management system, but it fits in exceptionally nicely with the pillars, pipelines, and vault system that we've been exploring throughout this whole series. Today, we're going to be looking at a feature to add to the knowledge vault, which is hot and cold topics. So the knowledge vault is where we take all the ideas and the best thinking and the best comments and insights and wisdom from all the books we read, the articles we read, the notes we take, the ideas we have, the conversations and presentations we go to. It all comes together by topic in the knowledge vault. And I did a whole other video on that if you're coming into this new. So definitely check that out. That explains how the knowledge vault works overall. Today, we're going to give an addition to the knowledge vault that makes it more accessible, easier to interact with quickly and efficiently. And that is hot and cold topics. Hot topics are the ones that we engage with more frequently on a very regular basis. Cold topics are ones that are still topics that we want to build knowledge on and insight in, but we're much less frequently engaging with them. So as you do more and more of this knowledge aggregation in this knowledge management system, your knowledge vault will be expanding and it will get bigger and bigger with more and more topics. And that's great. That's what you want to happen. That's what will make this one of the most valuable resources you own. We do have the ability to archive ones when they become no longer relevant to things we're working on. But for the most part, we have a lot of active ones that we're involved with regularly, at least week to week, if not day to day. And then we have some that we jump into periodically, maybe a few times a month or even less frequently, but they're still important to us and they're still relevant to things we're working on. So the hot and cold will help us separate, and I have an elegant way to integrate this into our mind expansion dashboard. And just a quick roadmap looking forward, the next one's going to look at some specialty vaults, the tech stack vault, and how we collect information on skills, people we might draw on, contractors, professional service categories, various resources we might draw on for our work, for our life, and a way that we can collect information on these as we go through life so that when we get to the point where we need them, all the information we've run across in the past is sitting there waiting for us. So that'll be the next video. And then after that, we're going to look at the concept of a master tag database. I've been on the fence about this one because there are pros and cons to it, but I've had a breakthrough idea on how to take the master tag database to the next level, and now I think it's a no-brainer. And all these additional enhancements are all coming together and aggregating to become version 2 of the Pillars, Pipelines, and Vault system. You're getting a sneak peek now at some of the version 2 features that have been creeping in and expanding across the system. And a lot of version 2 is about consolidating and simplifying while maintaining or even expanding the power of the original. So some of these videos coming up will further reveal some of the version 2 features. And speaking of version 2, the upcoming course is getting close. In the next couple weeks, I will be giving more details on what the course will involve, but essentially it's going to be the complete on-ramp and integration of the Pillars, Pipelines, and Vault system into your life. It'll be a much easier on-ramp than we have seen so far. I have fielded so many questions and discussed how to implement this in so many people's lives at this point. I have a very clear vision now on how to put it into action. And then the course will go deeper than just onboarding into the Pillars, Pipelines, and Vault system. It'll go into depth on how to integrate it into your life, make its principles a part of your daily living, and to bring clarity, alignment, and focus to everything you do, as well as bringing knowledge at your fingertips. So I'm really excited about what the course is going to enable, both for new people coming into the system and for veterans who have a system put together, but want to take it to the next level and want to more deeply integrate it into how they live. So if you're interested in that, be sure to hit the link below to be notified of course updates. And with that, let's dive in. We are back in the Mind Expansion dashboard. It looks a little bit different. Just a quick thought. I'm finding that I want to be able to access all the information more quickly without scrolling. So I have decided a lot of these top banner graphics are just in the way. They push the whole functional part of the page down just for the sake of decoration. And as the pages are getting better designs in and of themselves with the functionality, I'm feeling less of a need to decorate at the top. So I find that the ability to have more of it open just when I open the page without having to scroll even a few lines is an advantage that I'm willing to trade the graphic at the top for. We do need an icon here so that it is easy to spot when looking at it from other links and relational suggestion lists. I don't like how much room that takes up here. I wish we could consolidate that a bit, but that's what we get with the current Notion layout. I've also done a minor tweak in here from the previous video. I've collapsed these, removed the spaces between them so that they stack tighter, again, for the purpose of having easier, quicker access to the knowledge vault at the bottom, which before the extra lines just meant more scrolling. Now I get access to these more easily. I've removed the notes and ideas at the top. I'm finding I don't enter notes and ideas up here very often. I almost always do it either in the command center or in the action zone. And so I'm not going to use all that space just to have that entry up there. I have a separate page for quick entry where I have my smartphone set with a separate icon to go directly to a page that has nothing but quick entry, notes, and ideas. So here I do have a toggle where I can quickly add a note and entry here. It's not a big deal, but it's not emphasized like it was. Now the mind expansion page is more collapsed and more concise so that we can fit more in, and it works just as well as when it was more spread out. For those new to this, we've got articles, books, ways to access the various media that we're consuming and collecting ideas from. The new stuff is down here. So knowledge aggregation is the same area. It's got the same vault, the knowledge vault, but now we've got hot topics, cold topics, and all topics. I'm going to explain first what they are and then in what circumstances you want to use the hot cold topics and in what circumstances you don't, because there are systems out there that force you to use hot and cold topics. And sometimes it's a detriment to have that. It's not as helpful as using a global topic format, but sometimes it is helpful. And I'm going to talk about the distinction as to when it's better to use one or the other. In Notion, you can actually have either. Right here, I have the choice between all topics, which is every topic in here. And as you see, as you're getting more and more involved in different things, you're going to have more and more topic categories you want to build information on. So we have the all topics and hot topics and cold topics. So hot topics are going to be the topics in your knowledge vault that you're engaging with more frequently. And the benefit of having a hot topics section is that it's easier to find things quickly rather than sorting through the growing and large list of all your topics. You can just quickly grab at a much quicker glance the topics that you're interacting with most frequently. Then of course, cold topics are the topics you're less frequently interacting with. So they're still important to your life. They're still topics that you care about, but you're less actively engaged with them. So by having a cold topics as opposed to an all topics, you've already gone through here. If it's not in here, you can quickly jump down to the rest of them. Or you can keep it cleaner and just keep that one closed. I typically just keep the hot topics open because the hot topic strategy works well with the way I manage projects, which is what we're going to get into in a moment. So the previous video talked about how to lay out the gallery this way in this visual presentation. So if you're interested in that, check out the previous video. Now I'm going to talk about how to filter for hot and cold topics because it's very dynamic and it's largely automated. So the filter is set up with a few different selections. First of all, disregard the bottom one. Private is unchecked. That's just because I do these YouTube videos and public broadcasts. So I have some topics that I've checked as private so I can quickly filter for these. So when I do these public videos, it doesn't show all the private stuff. You don't need that unless you're doing public presentations or Zoom calls where you're sharing your system. We have the archive is unchecked filter because we have the option, a checkbox, to archive topics once they're no longer very active in our lives. And so we want to filter those out of any view. But the important one is this middle section here. And the first and more dynamic of the two is this: active projects, any is checked. And let me show you what that does. So let's go into product design, for example. Now, product design is connected to two different projects. This is a relational link to the projects database, and these are two projects in the projects database. Now, I have a roll up here to check whether they are active projects. So if you look here, we're looking at the projects database, we're looking at the active property, which I'll show you in just a second. And then we're showing the original. So the active property has a checkbox if the project is active, meaning it's one of the ones I'm currently actively focused on. Now, if we're linked to a project that is not active, it would show me a box, but it would be unchecked. So it's going to show all the boxes for all the projects, and it'll show which are checked and which are not checked. Now, if we look back here at the filter, we'll see it's checking whether active project has any that are checked. So if even one is checked, then it will pass this filter screening. Now I want to remind you how that checkbox is calculated in the projects database. It could just be a manual checkbox. If you want to just check the ones that are active, that's fine, and that'll be a very simple way to do it. But we do it a little bit differently, and I'll show you why. So we go back in product design, we'll click on projects, we'll click over to the projects database. Now these are all the active ones. We're filtering here for active is checked. So these are the active ones. Now, when we open this, we see that active is checked is actually a formula because the way we set active is with a single select. So active, on hold, next up, future, all those, just as we always have. But we created this active checkbox because we advance our goals by having multiple projects to achieve the goals. So we wanted to have a counter in the goals database, counting how many active projects we had. So we created this formula, which is just a very simple formula that checks whether status is active. If it's active, it's true. That means it's checked. If it's not active, it's false, which means it's unchecked. So we just have a simple formula to determine whether the dropdown status setting is active. If it is active, then we go back to product design and we're rolling up that active checkbox. It's listing all the boxes, whether they're checked or not. And then once again, our filter is checking whether any of the active project checkboxes are checked. If any are checked, then it passes the filter. So this means any Knowledge Vault topic that is linked to an active project will automatically appear here, which is what you want, because the topics that are connected to the active projects are the ones you're going to be most actively engaged with. Those are the projects you've defined as right now the ones you're focusing on. So automatically that happens just by managing the system as we always have. These are automatically selected. Now, occasionally there'll be some that are not connected to an active project, but you just find yourself going into them frequently. So for example, we have business building here. Now, this is a pretty broad one, and so I didn't link it directly to any of the projects. The projects are empty, but I've added a checkbox for a priority topic. So any topic that isn't inherently connected to an active project, see down here, active projects is empty because it's connected to no projects. Now, if we want to add it anyway, because we just find it's something that we're engaging with a lot, even though it's not connected to an active project, we have a checkbox here. See, I check it, you'll see things shuffling underneath. And this is what the second filter does. You check off the ones you want to add, regardless of whether they're in an active project or not. And we have another filter. The second one is priority topic is checked. So if either there's a checkbox for an active project or there's a priority topic checked, if either of those is true, then it will appear here. And then of course the cold topics are the exact opposite. So if the active projects rollup has no checks and the priority topic is not checked, then it's cold and this will be everything else. So you'd come in here and use these on a regular basis, then when you need to go to a less frequent one, you just pop into the cold topics. And even that has thinned it out because it's removed the hot topics. And then just so you have the option, we have all topics down here, which would be all of them, the hot and cold combined. It just doesn't have that filter. Now, some personal systems will benefit from hot topics and some will actually be hurt by it. And this is why the systems that force you into a hot and cold topic system are not always optimal for you. So hot and cold topic distinction is helpful if you're not cycling through projects on a really rapid rate. If you're frequently checking off projects, completing them on a frequent rate, then what's in the hot topic category is going to be changing so frequently, you're never gonna know where anything is. You're gonna always be wondering, oh wait, is that one active? Or is that a cold topic? Where is it? And then you're going to find yourself going to the wrong folder and then having to go to the other folder more and more frequently. So if you're cycling through projects quickly, then it's better just to go to the all topics organization structure, because then you can just, it's all alphabetical, it's all there. You're not going to have to go hunting through multiple boxes. But if your project stays static long enough that you get familiar with the organization, because if they're here for a month or so, you're going to be familiar not just with the alphabetical sorting, but really the positioning in the layout. You're just going to jump to the right part of the grid here. But if they're cycling through and changing all the time, you're going to be hunting through boxes, and that's no good. So if your projects are a bit longer term, then I recommend using this hot and cold topics, and that's the case with me. But if your topics are changing frequently because your active projects are changing frequently, I recommend just having a single all topic categorization, and then everything will be in place, and you'll still be learning the positioning very quickly. And the positioning will be staying the same. It won't keep changing on you. So that's going to be helpful. So that's pretty much it. Hope that's helpful. But this is something you can add to pretty much any knowledge information system. And I think it's worth distinguishing between when it's helpful and when it's not. It should be obvious to you which is better for you. And if not, then go ahead and try one. And if it becomes a problem, just go ahead and switch to the other. In the next video, we'll dive into a couple more specialty categories, how to aggregate in all your research on skills from people, skills from professional services, and how to aggregate all of your research and knowledge on your tech stack, the technology and software that you use or you might potentially use in the future. And then we get into the master tag database, which will be a fun exploration because it's something I really see a lot of pros and cons to, but I'm excited to share with you my breakthrough insight on how to do this in a way that I think takes it to the next level. And of course, if you're interested in the course, be sure to sign up at the link below for notifications of the course launch announcement. Or if you're watching this a few weeks afterwards, it may already be out. So definitely check the link below to see what's up with the course. The course is going to be the complete aggregation of everything I know about how to implement this system into your life. I am putting everything I have into it. So I am super excited about what this course is going to open up. But regardless of whether or not you take the course, do not fear. This YouTube series will continue. I will continue to share with you ways to enhance the Pillars, Pipelines, and Vaults system, and we're going to expand beyond that into how to bring other life enhancement practices into the way you live your life to further enable you to achieve the things that matter to you in life. And that's what all of this is all about. This is not about building cool systems. This is about enhancing our lives, and the channel will continue in great depth on all those topics, including the enhancements to the Notion system. If this is of interest, be sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to get updates on future videos. Leave thoughts or questions below, or join us on Twitter for a broader conversation. And hit like if you found this video valuable. I also write a newsletter called Mind and Machine on increasing human capability. I give away several of my best Notion templates to anyone who subscribes to the newsletter. You can, of course, unsubscribe at any time, but I hope you'll give it a chance. I work super hard to pack it with a lot of valuable insight. The newsletter link is also below in the show notes. Thanks for watching. Lots more to come.